This is the Nissan 370Z Nismo. It's a sports car tuned by the brand's Motorsport division, and it offers something that many modern sports cars fail to: a raw, unadulterated driving experience. In fact, if modern sports cars are a Swiss Army knife juggling everyday practicality with comfort and fuel efficiency, the 370Z is a screwdriver in comparison. It does just one thing, but boy, does it do it well. From the outside, the 370Z has remained relatively unchanged since its launch in 2009, but that isn't such a bad thing. It doesn't look outdated by any means, and since this is the Nismo version, it gets a few exciting upgrades. For starters, the Nismo is longer and wider than the standard 370Z, and that is because of the different bumpers it receives, the beautiful body kit, and the 19-inch raised alloy wheels that are wider than those on the standard car. The Nismo also differentiates itself with darkened headlamps, dark chrome on the door handles, and blacked out side mirrors with a neat red stripe running horizontally across. Minimalistic and driver focused, the cabin of the 370Z looks dated by modern standards, but what's important is that everything serves a specific purpose. The purpose? To provide a better driving experience. Recaro Sport seats covered in a combination of leather and Alcantara. Why? For a better driving experience. A steering wheel covered in a combination of leather and Alcantara. Why? For a better driving experience. An instrument cluster attached to the steering column. Why? For a better driving experience. Although these are just a few things, it doesn't take much to see that the 370Z is all about the driver and the experience behind the wheel. In fact, many people are likely to get into the car and complain about the lack of storage spaces for things like their mobile phone. But if you ask me, I think Nissan's done that intentionally. Nissan wants you to keep your phone in your pocket, your hands on the steering wheel, and enjoy the 370Z to the fullest. If there's one angle of the 370Z that truly reveals its age, it would have to be the technology. There isn't a lot more than an ancient 7-inch infotainment screen, a rear-view camera, cruise control, and a banging 8-speaker Bose sound system. Is it a deal-breaker though? Not one bit. Under the hood of the 370Z is a 3.7-litre naturally aspirated V6. And what a pleasant change at a time when most other manufacturers are downsizing and going with forced induction through turbos and superchargers. Nissan has stuck to the old school approach, and the benefit of this is that you can rev the engine right up to 7,400 RPM and hear it scream before shifting into the next gear. Power for the Nismo stands at 350 horsepower, which is 22 more than the standard car, and torque measures in at 374 Newton meters, which is 12 more than the standard Z. Unlike newer cars, it's also only fitted with a 7-speed automatic transmission, but it does come with downshift rev matching. For those of you who know what downshift rev matching is, you're probably smiling right now, and for those who don't, it's basically a system that blips the throttle to make sure you're at the perfect RPM in every gear so that you can accelerate hard out of every corner. It's essentially an advanced driving technique used by race car drivers, except now, regular people like you and I can perform it as well. Speaking of the transmission and how brilliant it is, I will highlight that it is very mechanical. You feel every shift, you hear every shift, and while many people might find this uncomfortable, I personally love it. It's raw, it's engaging, and it's what you'd expect from a proper sports car. Unlike modern sports cars that are fitted with electric steering, the 370Z has a hydraulic steering system. What this means is that it's heavier, but way more precise and delivers a lot more feedback. The smallest of adjustments to the steering can be seen and felt with the 370Z ready to change direction and attack the next corner. To make you understand just how simple and raw the 370Z is, It doesn't come with any fancy electronic systems or drive modes. It's loud, it's harsh, it's engaging. It's essentially in race mode 24/7. And that's what a true sports car is meant to be. Something that almost all other manufacturers have forgotten because they're so busy trying to come up with the ideal everyday sports car. Dedicated to performance on the street and track, the 370Z comes with a tuned suspension setup with stiffer springs, shocks, and stabilizer bars to reduce body roll in fast corners. The engineer's dedication to performance and weight reduction is also seen with the introduction of aluminium on the boot and carbon fiber on the drive shaft. For the slightly more technical viewers, we have long been told that the perfect weight distribution in a car is 50-50, right? But Nissan's engineers beg to differ. In fact, the weight distribution on the 370Z is 53 front and 47 rear. Why? Because the front needs to be heavier to dig into the tarmac and grip better when entering a corner. And when accelerating out of a corner, the weight is pushed back, balancing out to a perfect 50-50. Now, isn't that smart? I'm sure you've all heard of the saying, old is gold. And it is definitely true in case of the Nissan 370Z. At 184,500 dirhams, it is not a cheap purchase. But then again, the 370Z is not for everyone. It's for the automotive enthusiasts. It's for the driving enthusiasts. It's for the men and women who don't care if it doesn't have the latest technology, because when behind the wheel, it offers an experience that only a few can match. So let's enjoy it. Let's celebrate it. Because who knows, it might be the last naturally aspirated Z from Nissan, or the last Z at all. Thanks for watching.